He's one of the best selling artists of all time.
Yes.
That's crazy.
Yes.
Man.
Yes.
That's major.
Yes.
He's a philanthropist, a designer. He's a father. He does it all. And now I'm happy to announce, for the first time ever, Young Brother has released his first urban adult gospel single. That's amazing, man. Mm. Let's find out about the new song. Please welcome to the show, the one and only, Mr. Kanye West.
Yay!
Yo, what's up? Morning.
Hey, what's up with you, man?
I'm feeling good. Feeling great.
Man, hey, man. First of all, thank you for calling. Happy to hear from you, man. Amazing reinvention of yourself over and over and over again. You just keep doing it, man. What inspires you to always look for change, seems like?
You know, dreams and purpose. You know, what my mother would have wanted for me, what my dad would have wanted for me, with the way how they were educated and the way they educated me, you know, always pushed me to push past, you know, the regular limitations, you know, no matter what level you're supposedly at. Mm-hmm. I remember I lived a year in China with my mom, and my mom went over there as an English professor to teach advanced Chinese English students. And she homeschooled me for a year. So when I got back, they had me do some tests to see where I'd end up in the grades. I was in fifth grade at that time. I did so good on the test that they had to retest me in the middle of the classroom. They put me in a desk in the middle of the classroom because they thought that it was something. But that let me know that I had been being taught at a level that I wasn't reaching my full potential. I wasn't thinking to my maximum potential. I wasn't being allowed to think to my maximum potential. Wow. And that's kind of been the story ever since. Anytime y'all ever heard me scream or jump up and down or whatever it was, it's because I wanted to bring the people something to a higher potential than what the powers that control the money, control the image, control the media, control the perception wanted me to.
Wow.
You know what, man? That's interesting because you've always said that. We were doing Fallon one night, and you had surprised the audience. And the audience didn't know Kanye was coming, so they were, you know, older audience kind of sitting there. They from Nebraska and Butte, Iowa. You know, you don't know where they from. They just tourists.
Yeah.
And they sitting there, and Kanye went out there and performed, and we were sitting on the couch. And I don't know if you remember this, but he said, man, they don't even realize what they being fed. Because they don't, man. They don't know. And he's always felt that way about himself. He said they don't even realize what they're being fed. Because they were just kind of sitting there. First of all, you got Kanye by surprise. Hell, that threw their
first
ass
thing.
A little bit. Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. They was ass out naked on that one. They were sitting there. They were sitting up in there trying to come to grips with that. But you've always said that, man. So I really, really believe that about you, man. You've always strived for that higher level.
Man, I want to do something that helps the world and impacts and represents our time here on Earth to the maximum. I mean, within 100 years of the internet being created, within 100 years of sneakers, there's a time when people couldn't get into the club if they had on Jordans. Now's the time you can't get into the club if you don't have on Jordans. So, it's a time where we are like ageless. It'd be the same, be the daughter and the mom be up in the club dancing a Young Thug in the same song.
It ain't, yeah.
There is no separation. So here on our time on Earth, you know what I mean? Like, what are we doing to really inspire and help each other? So what I really want to explain is, like, you know, people got me messed up. They don't understand. Anytime I ever get in trouble, I was jumping in front of a bullet for somebody else.
Yeah.
We love you, Kanye.
Hey, Kanye. Man.
That's real.
They back there quiet.
Every time I got in trouble, hell, I was jumping in front of a bullet for somebody else.
Thank you for him.
And it's just that I care, man. I'm telling you, I care, man. I care past the idea of my own perception. I care past the own idea of my own celebrity. I care past the idea of what deal I might lose, what deal I might gain. I feel like in this new information highway, this new era where the information is so free, that truth is going to come to light. And, you know, they want to sell you something, but the truth is going to come to light.
Yeah.
They can't deny it. When those kids be lined up for those Yeezys, that truth came to light. When Title Triple Subscriptions, when we dropped that Pablo, that truth came to light. And I'm only doing 1% of the work. I'm just trying to step up and do just half of my job.
Right.
You know, and the rest of it is an ultralight beam flowing through me. I'm merely a vessel. But me and my dad went to go visit Kurt at his house like 4 Christmases ago. That was the beginning of a relationship. You know, you just can't call Kurt Franklin out of the blue and he's just like, okay, cool.
come on.
Yeah. Hey, man, let's talk about that, because Ultra Light Beam, that's your new single. It features Kirk Franklin and Kelly Price. So how did the collaboration came up? You say you went to his house a few years ago, but how did this song come about?
Man, I mean, we were just blessed to be in the room at the right time when the Ultra Light Beam it just came through us. I can't explain that song in notes. I can't explain it in rhythm. I can't explain it in drum beats. I can only explain that feeling. I mean, I'm saying there's a young lady in the studio that pulled up the Instagram with the little girl on it, saying that we don't want no devils in the house. Like, literally, this is all coming together a week and a half before the album, to the point where we had to make it the first song on the album. And when we did that show at Madison Square Garden, the presentation, which sold out in 10 minutes, 16,000 people coming to a fashion show.
Yeah.
And we took the 1,000 people that were covered, and when Kirk's choir opened up at the end and we exposed those 1,000 people, I mean, people just, I think that was a little moment of possibility that I was able to express for the 8 times that I've met with Walt Disney and said, look, man, I ain't got no more money at this point. I've done shot films. I've done fashion. Could you just help me put together a production company so that I can, like, make some more dope stuff for the world? And they look and they start reading TMZ and talking about that. I said, what about the fact that I'm your son's idol? When are you going to be? When I look at the options, and I've seen all the black actors going in and blah blah. It's like, nah, yeah, right. Get on your yay, because you know we ain't getting those opportunities. You know, right.
Get on your yay.
You said you in there talking to Disney. They start pulling up TMZ stories. You say, yeah, but damn that. What about the fact that I'm your boy, I am? You know, while exactly. TMZ has a purpose and a mission, just like all blog sites. They got the blog. It's like a movie critic or a music critic. If they ain't criticizing, their ass is out of work. You understand? The critic got to be critical. So if you look at everything they say on the internet and you go from there, if that's the square you starting from, your ass already done lost.
Damn.
Yeah, man. You got critics and then you got artists. I kick a critic out the studio. I didn't read one review on my fashion show. I didn't read one review on The Life of Pablo. The only review is somebody waking up in the morning and listening to Ultra Light Beam. Somebody listening to Low Life, a single mom driving a son to work like the way my mom used to drive, driving a son to school the way my mom used to drive me to school. Like taking the people, the creators that are around me to present, to give that feeling the way I was, me and my mom in Chicago. I wanted to, that's another thing on the clothing line. Man, that first season, I wasn't in charge of none of those prices. Mark my words, please mark my words. Mm-hmm. Like, I am coming for the neck. I'm about to drop these prices in a way that I can connect to the Kanye that I was when I was 14 years old and my mom could barely afford it.
Wow.
We trying to take the information that only goes to Louis Vuitton, to Celine, the type of designers that only, I had to present myself in a way where that type of design group that only works for what goes into that Celine bag would work for me. And I'm going to take that and bring that to the people, like Robin Hood, because I believe that beauty, color, proportion, shape, that's important, man. It's more colors that's important than just green, man. All these colors are important.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, man, you know, like he said about he didn't read the critics with the fashion review. It was 16,000 people trying to get into this show. I've been to the Chanel show in Paris with my girl, who gets invited every year. I ain't seen 16,000 people at no fashion show. Nowhere.
All right.
Nowhere, man. For him to draw that type of crowd,
it's
because he has a way. He has an attraction to people.
A movement.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
mostly it's because of his just sheer honesty. You know, it's hard to find that, you know, man, in people. Just look, this is me, like it or accept it or not. This is me. Now, when you get through with all of what you got to say, damn, dog, this is still just me. Mm-hmm. And me been working because he one of the all-time greatest selling artists out there, you know. So you got some stuff behind you, man. I'm impressed with you on a lot of levels. I laugh with you on a lot of levels because I know where it's coming from. Hey, when we come back right after this 15 second break, more with Kanye West.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show. We'll be right back in 15 seconds.
All right, y'all, we back with Kanye West. You know, the whole Taylor.
Oh, man, I think, would you bring in a Wiz with the kids, man? Because when you read the KK, you thought that he might have been talking about my wife. And you know how you would feel if someone was talking about your wife. Did I take it too far? Hey, you know what? I'm from 79th Street, Chicago.
There you go, Yeezy. Come on, Kanye.
Somebody's talking about my wife. Mm-hmm. I can't say that if someone, like, you know, says F you, that I'm just going to say the exact same thing back. I ain't going to try to tell you I'm about to play fair. I'm just saying, when I get on my zone. But, you know, one thing I want to really express to the people is every day that, you know, I look and I play with my daughter. I'm playing with Saint. And I think about that concept. I really want to, I've talked to Wiz. Amber's talked to Kim, but I really want to really stress the amount of respect that I have for parents and that there is no concept of anyone being able to own someone else's child or that type of concept. So every day I actually feel more deeply apologetic about that concept, because I only want to put out positive concepts. I think the defense of my wife came from a number of layers and levels that didn't have to just do with a rap community feeling like they could disrespect her in any way because of anything that they've seen or heard in the past. It isn't just that. It's the fact that she's breaking boundaries on so many levels. From, you can't give me an example of as popular of a mixed couple. And I got friends that have had, like, you know, white wives that before there was a Kimye, they'd go to the amusement park and people would be talking down to them, treating them a certain kind of way.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? She broke boundaries. With that, she also broke boundaries in fashion, where designers wasn't trying to make clothes for women with shapes. And now they're all about really embracing and empowering women. Women empowering, and empowerment of a matriarch society, you know, where women can make money. Like when she said, okay, y'all, my husband might have invested everything he had into fashion, everything he had in creativity, to breaking these boundaries. But you know what? We straight. I put the money in account. So don't be talking about what I ain't got to wear and this and blah, blah. As a family, all of those statements means that can't nobody ever disrespect my wife. Period.
Hello. Yeah. Hello.
Right now.
I ain't mad at you. Mm-hmm. See, we getting off into the manhood side of it. It's not about the business or it's not about the fame. Every man should feel that way about his wife. If you don't protect the honor and the name of your wife, what you got her for? See, your punk ass should have just went on, just had some chicks on the side and all this here. But once you have a wife, this man got children by this woman. Look, man, it when you start messing with a dude's wife and his kids, oh, man, you finna find out a whole lot about him you didn't know. That 79th.
The Chicago coming out.
See, the 79th is always close by.
Okay.
No matter how big,
that's what I like about 79. That's like 112th Street is always close by. He's within arm's reach, and if I need it, I bring it up. Yeah. Now your ass want to all of a sudden get real bougie after that. It's too late. 79th is here. Damn it, I'm sorry. But 79th is here.
Yeah.
We doing 79. Hey, Kanye, let me ask you this, man. The new album, The Life of Pablo, debuted at number one, and it's dominating the charts. You planning to go on tour with this album here? What are your thoughts, man?
Oh, you know my tour game is strong. My tour game is unprecedented.
Here, Jay.
He said my tour game is strong. I know that's right, man.
Yeah. So we're going to go out in September, I believe, and we're just working on some of the ideas right now. But as I said before, it's like I'm trying to literally inspire these kids the way Disney inspired me. The way, you know, when I first saw the original Star Wars, it's that conversation. And everybody that made from George Lucas to who, everybody know, they know. The people that run Hollywood know.
Yeah, they know.
Tour game is strong, man.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I love it.
Hey, man, you ain't lying. Man. They know. They know for real, man. Hey, brother, listen to me. We're going to play Ultra Light Beam on the show this morning. But talking to you, man, it's been a real pleasure. I think it's important, man, when people hear from the real man himself instead of getting all your information off the internet. I think it's important when people know that there is a feeling behind it. He said something that really stuck with me. He said, every time I did something crazy, man, I was really taking a bullet for somebody else. Mm. And if you look back at it, the dude was standing up to say, hey, man, y'all wrong about this. How y'all passing out all this and you overlook this or you overlook her?
Yeah.
Man, y'all out here, you missing it. I wish I was, you know.
Man.
You know, man, look, man, I'll be 60
before
on my next
off, birthday. I know you want to talk about Taylor.
No, I really wasn't, but go ahead, though. but go ahead, though, dog.
You know, that situation, it's not about Kanye West, not about Taylor Swift. It's that thing that, you know, I'm not going to mention no politician's names. I'm just saying that there's a lot of people in America that feel like they now had a platform to stand up and express their closet racism.
Mm.
Mm. Now, before they had that platform, one really easy way to express it was to say F Kanye West. We was brought over here as unpaid interns, bro. Lincoln turned us to assistants.
Unpaid interns.
Lincoln turned us into assistants. This boy got a class I'm going to today.
Yeah, I'm taking the yay class.
I'm taking this class.
It don't have to. Soon as Britney shaved her head and they saw that money going down, they had already marked what that award was going to be that night. They didn't expect activist that had just lost his mama a year later, sitting there with a bottle of Hennessy. The only reason why I drank the Hennessy in the first place is because I said, I'm going to have to just get drunk to deal with all the lies I'm about to see.
Come on, Jesus. That's what I do next.
That's a real moment right there, Kanye.
To deal with all the lies I'm going to have to hear now. I got you, man. I got you, man.
Wow. Amazing.
Man.
Hey, man, you do this for me, brother. Stay fearless, man. Stay fearless, because the world is greater when people are fearless. When people take chances, when people go forward against the odds, when people defy everything that's been said about them, when people go against the grain, those are the people, man, that make changes in this world. The people that do the unexpected, the exceptional on a daily basis until it becomes almost like regular occurrence. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
Hey, man, I love you, man. I do, brother. I'm proud of you, man. You've turned yourself into a fine young man, and I don't think people understand the pressure that come with fame. Most people ain't famous, so they can't know that there ain't no book for this, man. You just got to wake up every day and hear it come. And so, hey, man, Yeezy, man, I appreciate you, boy. We're gonna play this song, Ultra Light Beam, man. Thank you for your time this morning. Thank you for your honesty, man, and stay fearless, soldier.
Oh, all love. Thank you.
All right, black man, for sure. The one and only Kanye West.
That was classic right there, buddy.
Morning show.
That was classic.
It is what it is. Kanye. Wow.